So let us start the next section of registration. As I have told you earlier, that registration is covered in around nine sections precisely, starting from section 22 to section 30. We have already covered sections 22 to 28, and now let us start section 29. Section 29 of the CGST Act deals with cancellation of registration, or suspension of registration. In what circumstances my registration certificate can be cancelled by the department? And what is the process of suspension also? During what time limit? Or for what period the certificate will be suspended? So suspension is basically temporary mode. Cancellation is permanent mode. So let me share with you the Act, Section 29. So that I can show what the Act talks about as far as Section 29 is concerned, cancellation is concerned, suspension is concerned, and then I will simplify the language for you. So first let me share with you the Act. I hope it is visible now. If yes, then you can see Section 29 of the CGST Act. Cancellation or suspension of registration. Cancellation or suspension of registration. It is my subsection 1, and what these first two lines says, only read these two lines which are highlighted. The proper officer may, either on his own motion or on an application filed by the registered person. That means under subsection 1, there are two manner of cancellation. For the time being, two manner. Manner means who can, manner means what is how? How we can cancel these registration? First, department can initiate the cancellation on its own, or as an applicant, as a registered person, I can also file for cancellation myself. That is why. So the cancellation, of course, can always be done by the department, because I as an applicant cannot cancel the registration. It will be done by the department, but on whose request it will be cancelled? Department itself can cancel it. If proper officer thinks that there are circumstances which require cancellation, or the registered person can also make an application in this behalf that cancel my registration. So both the options are covered here. Either officer can cancel the registration on its own motion or on an application filed by the registered person. Now, as far as the manner is concerned, for this we have rules. As you can see, in such manner and within such period as may be prescribed. So we have some rules. Now, rules I'm not showing you because it will become very lengthy then to complete the course. But we have set frame of rules, which application form has to be filled. Exactly. So I'm not showing the rules. I simply wanted to show you that we have subsection 1 of section 29, which says that application can be filed by the registered person, or department can also initiate the cancellation on its own. Now we have subsection 2 and see what it says. This is subsection 2. The proper officer may cancel the registration of a person from such date, including retrospective date, as he may deem fit. That means in subsection 2, application cannot be filed by the applicant or by the registered person. Department can initiate the cancellation on its own. So technically now there are two categories. There are some situations where department can initiate the cancellation on its own, or registered person can also file an application in this behalf for cancellation. Category 2, where registered person cannot file an application, department can cancel the registration on its own. So I will discuss these two categories, that what are those situations where both can make an application technically, department as well as the registered person. And second, those situations where department can initiate application from applicant or registered person is not at all required. Then we have subsection 3. And the section little bit, subsection 4 and subsection 5. Now let me simplify these five sections of section 29, five subsections of section 29 for you. So let me share my notepad. I simply wanted to show you that in subsection 1 of section 29, both can make an application technically. And in subsection 2, only the proper officer can initiate the cancellation on its own. So let me share with you the notepad, just to simplify the language of the act. I hope this screen is visible. So the topic which is going on is registration. And within registration now, I'm discussing with you cancellation or suspension of registration. Section 29. Now, if you remember this act which I have just shown, I am framing two categories, category 1 and category 2. In category 1, which cases are covered? Where the cancellation can be done by the, of course, cancellation is always done by the proper officer, but on the basis of his own decision by the proper officer, on his own motion, when he himself thinks that cancellation is necessary, or on a request from the registered person. Okay, so these are the any of these two can initiate this request. But in category 2, applicant or registered person cannot make the application, where the cancellation can be done by the proper officer on his own motion. Now let me first discuss these cases, category 1. Now, in the following cases, now which are those cases where cancellation can be done by the officer on his own or a request from the registered person? Now, first point, where the registered person, where the business of the registered person has been discontinued, Suppose I have discontinued my business. So technically, I do not need any registration certificate now if I have closed my business, discontinued. Or what? Amalgamates with other entity. Then old entity does not need registration. Amalgamated. Or amalgamates. Demerge. In all these situations, the old entity doesn't require continuation of registration certificate. Transferred. Or if not transferred, at least disposed of. Just like selling the items to a scrap dealer. Or disposed of. That's it. In these circumstances, what happens is that the registered person or the officer on his own motion can initiate the process of cancellation of registration certificate. Next point. Now, where the assessee himself or herself is not required, is not liable to be registered under Section 22 or Section 24. Where? Then why do I need registration? For example, my turnover is not exceeding 20 lakh or 10 lakh in any previous year. Then why do I need any registration? If I am liable, if my turnover exceeds the turnover, I have no option. I have to take registration. But if my turnover does not exceed the limits, then legally or compulsorily, I'm not supposed to take any registration. Now, if I myself want registration, government says no problem, but there is no obligation on me. That is why, where the registered person or taxable person is not liable for registration under Section 22, which talks about turnover limit basically, or under Section 24, compulsory liable cases. Then either applicant can file for cancellation of registration or department can initiate the action on its own. Now, third point. Suppose I have taken voluntary registration. Now, if I have taken voluntary registration and I don't want to continue that voluntary registration, where this registered person rather than a registered person, I should technically use the word taxable person. I will tell you the meaning later on why. But I should use the word taxable because every person who has taken the registration under Section 22 or 24 will be treated as taxable person. So you can use, for your level, you can use the language of registered person or taxable person, same thing. But in reality, there is a difference. So where the taxable person, of course, every registered person is taxable person, is willing to opt out, is willing to opt out of voluntary registration. Now suppose earlier I have taken the registration myself. Even if my turnover was not exceeding the limit, I have taken the registration. Now I am willing to opt out of voluntary registration. Government says no problem. When you took registration voluntarily, then also there was no legal obligation on you. Now, if you are opting out of voluntary registration, now also there is no legal obligation for you. You have a right to cancel your registration. There is no problem. And last point, where the constitution of the business is changed. Suppose the constitution of business is totally changed, then also I need a new registration. So I have to cancel this registration. These are the four points where either the applicant or the registered person or the department can initiate the process of cancellation. If I have transferred my business, if I am not liable for registration now, when I am willing to opt out of voluntary registration, or when there is a change in the constitution of business, then any of these two can initiate the request. But some points to be noted in this regard. First, what is the manner of cancellation? Now, in the heading, I have discussed only two manners. In the heading, if you remember, I just told you that either the officer can cancel or request of the registered person. But suppose a registered person is died, so one more set of people can make an application. So technically, the manner means, first, proper officer on his own. This is first. Second, application by the registered person. Application by the registered person. And third, application by the legal heirs of the registered person in case death of the registered person happens. Application by the legal heirs in case of death of the registered person. Now, this is the way basically in which cancellation will start. Either the officer will cancel the registration himself or herself, or he will wait for the application of the registered person, or in case the registered person has died, unfortunately, then legal heirs will file the application on behalf of the deceased registered person. Then next point, what is the time limit of making an application? What is the time limit? What is the time limit? To apply for cancellation. Now, if today business is discontinued, it's not that you will wait for 5 years to cancel your certificate. No, the moment your business is discontinued, the moment you are willing to opt out of voluntary registration, the moment your constitution of business is changed, the moment you are no longer liable to be registered, while you are waiting for applying for cancellation, apply within 30 days. This is the time limit. As an applicant, as a registered person, I should apply within 30 days from the date of occurrence of any of the above events. From the date of occurrence of any of the above mentioned events. So you have 30 days. Within 30 days, if any of these above four situations happens, these four, then you apply for cancellation. Don't wait. Now, it doesn't mean that cancellation will happen the moment you apply. It will take some time. Department will verify your application, so it will take some time. So in the meantime, your registration can be suspended. So then we have a concept of suspension of registration. Now today, if you have applied for cancellation, it doesn't mean that the cancellation will happen today itself. It will take some time. And now I have told you that there are two different categories of people who can make the application: officer himself or on the basis of application by the person or by the legal heirs. Now in both the cases, the date of suspension will vary. Like case when proper officer, case when proper officer on his own motion proceeds for cancellation. On his own motion proceeds for cancellation. In this point, what happens? What is the effective date of suspension of registration? From which date registration will be treated as suspended? The date of suspension. See, suspension is a temporary phase. Permanent cancellation is a different phase. So it is suspension. Like when someone is terminated from the job, that is permanent termination. But pending inquiry, till inquiry happens, the person is not terminated, person is suspended. Same is the case here. Till inquiry or findings, registration will be suspended, not cancelled. So the date of suspension will be the date as deemed fit by the, as determined by the proper officer, that's it. As determined by the proper officer, he will determine, he or she will determine. This is first point. And then case, when cancellation is on the basis of request from the registered person. Request or application on the basis of, you can say that on the basis of an application. An application. So application will be by the registered person or by the legal heirs. In this case, the date is different. The date is not the date which officer will determine. The date is what the act says. So the date of suspension will be, the date of suspension will be the date of submission of application, the date of submission of application, or the date from which cancellation is sought. Whichever is later. This is the point. Now the date, for example, on 5th September 20, I made an application. I applied for cancellation. But in that application, I have mentioned that please cancel my certificate from 12th September. For example, I have mentioned that I need the cancellation from 12th September. It is what I desired for. So which is later, 12th. So 12th September is the date, effective date of suspension of cancellation. From 12th October till the decision on cancellation is taken, my registration will be treated as suspended. It's just like that, I cannot use it. This is the suspension of registration. And last point. Cancellation cannot be done without giving me the opportunity of being heard. Cancellation cannot be done. And it is the principle of natural justice, where you have been given your given the sufficient time to file your reply in this behalf. Cancellation cannot be done without giving the reasonable opportunity. Of being heard. Now this is what my subsection 1 of section 29 is, which I have simplified for you. I have told you some cases where registration can be cancelled on the basis of a request from the taxable person or registered person or by the department on its own, and some notes I have mentioned. Please raise your hand if it is clear till this point. Then I'll proceed to next concept. Okay, great. So let us proceed to the next concept where only officer can initiate the cancellation application. So let me discuss now section 29 subsection. I hope this slide is still visible. So this is next point now. Category 2. Now I'll be going to discuss with you this category. Category 2, where cancellation can be done by the proper officer. This is my second category. Now, application from applicant is not required. Application from registered person is not required. Department can suo motu initiate the cancellation first, where the registered person has not followed the following provisions, where the registered person has contravened the following provisions. First point, if this person is not doing the business, is not conducting the business from declared place of business, because in this certificate, whatever declared place I have mentioned, if I'm not doing the business from that place, that means we're not following the provisions. I have taken the registration for a place, for example, Morris Nagar of Delhi, and I'm doing the business from Nehru Place area of Delhi, which are totally different. So what is this declared place? So why I'm not doing the business from this declared place of business? If I'm not willing to do the business from declared place of business, let the registration be cancelled. Second, I have issued the bill. Technically, under GST laws, we use it, call it as tax invoice. I have issued tax invoice or bill of supply. I will tell the bill later on, without actually supplying goods or services. It's a total fraud. Without supplying goods or services or both, I issued the bill, issued the tax invoice without supply. How is it possible? So government says, no, your registration is liable to be cancelled. If availed ITC wrongly. Why you have fraudulently taken ITC? If availed ITC wrongly or incorrectly, then you don't deserve that you should be allowed to proceed with the registration. The registration is liable to be cancelled and lost. If I violate the provisions of Rule 86B, I violate the provisions of Rule 86B. I will tell you these rules later on. But in these four situations, registration is liable to be cancelled. Department will cancel, has to cancel it, liable to be cancelled. So these are the cases where registration is liable to be cancelled. In fact, even the proper officer has no freedom not to cancel it. These four, there are three or four more situations which I'm not discussing, not relevant for you. But these are those four situations for your course where registration is liable to be cancelled. Next point, where department can initiate the cancellation request without having an application from the principal. Where a registered person being composition levy scheme supplier. Now, if I'm that person who is covered under composition levy scheme, being a composition levy scheme supplier, failed in submitting, failed in furnishing my return for three consecutive tax periods. Now, I'm not discussing the period of tax returns because some people have to submit the return on monthly basis, some have to submit on quarterly basis, some have to submit on annual basis, etc. So I'm not discussing that procedure right now. That I will discuss in the chapter of return. Different categories of people have different requirements of submitting the returns. So whatever is that tax period for composition levy scheme supplier, if for three consecutive tax periods you have not submitted the return, then your registration can be cancelled by the proper officer. Failed in furnishing the return for three consecutive tax periods. Consecutive tax periods. Now, if I'm not a composition levy scheme supplier, but a registered person, then if I'm not submitting the return for 6 continuous months, then I also need, then the department can cancel my registration where a registered person other than a person who is in composition, other than a composition levy other than a composition levy scheme supplier failed in furnishing the return for continuous period of 6 months. You can write in this way. For a continuous period of 6 months. Then proper officer can cancel my registration. Fourth, where I have taken voluntary registration, but I...
Can you get to the previous slide, sir?
Yeah, please.
Thank you, sir.
Fourth. Now, suppose I have taken voluntary registration, but I'm not starting the business for next 6 months. Government says, then why you have taken the voluntary registration? So if I have taken a voluntary registration, but I'm not starting the business, commencing the business within 6 months of taking the registration, then the department can cancel my registration. Where a registered person who has taken voluntary registration is not commencing the business, has not commenced the business, not is, has not commenced the business within 6 months. Of the date of taking registration. Then also the department can cancel my registration. And fifth point, where the registration has been taken by fraud, where the registration has been taken by fraud, oblique misrepresentation of facts. Misrepresentation of fact. That means in all these five circumstances, the proper officer can initiate the cancellation of registration. I am, as an applicant or as a registered person, I'm not supposed to file any written. Department itself can initiate the process of cancellation of registration. These are the two categories of section 29. Now let me discuss with you my third point. And the third point is, now third point, cancellation does not affect, this is my third point. Now I have discussed with you circumstances where registration can be cancelled. Now next point is, cancellation does not affect the liability when I use the word tax liability, by default I am talking about GST, the tax liability oblique other dues of the period prior to cancellation. Now just because my registration is cancelled, I cannot say that I will not pay any GST now. Government says why? Now for example, I would like to explain this with the help of an example. March 13th 2021, my registration certificate is cancelled. Now what about the period which is till 12th March? What about the period which is till 12th March? Government says just because your registration is cancelled on 13th, it does not mean that you will not pay the outstanding dues of this period. That is still payable. This due is still payable even after 13th March. You should have paid it by 12th March, but just because the registration is cancelled on 13th March, it does not make you free. It does not free you not to pay any GST or other liabilities related to GST laws of the period which is prior to cancellation. So these are still payable. And these are payable even if, these are payable even if determined after cancellation. Even if determined after cancellation. Not, you cannot say that till 12th March, department has not informed me to pay. Department is informing me after 2 months. For example, department is informing you on 14th June 2021. On 14th June 2021, you got to know that you have to pay some tax of this period. You cannot say no just because it is informed you after cancellation. No, government says maybe we are also busy, department is also busy, department has so many work to do. So just because your liability amount has been given to you or has been told you after cancellation of certificate, it does not absolve you. Or you cannot treat that the amount is not payable. You have to still pay the amount because at least it belongs to the period which is prior to registration. I hope you are understanding my point. If yes, please raise your hand. If not, then ask me the query. If yes, please raise your hand. Okay, next point. Very good. Next point. Now, if you remember, deemed registration, that once your registration has been given or amended as per the state or UT Act, by default it is amended as per the Central Act. Same is the case in cancellation, deemed cancellation. If the cancellation has been done under the State Act, because you are registered in a state or UT, or UT Act, by default, it will be treated as, it will be deemed to be cancelled. Under Central Act. It will be deemed to be cancelled under the Central Act. By default, it is normal thing. And last point. Payment of tax. Last point is payment of tax. By the person whose registration is cancelled. This is last point. Now I would like to explain this with the help of a simple example. Now this is a person, he is a seller as well as purchaser. Here he is a purchaser and now he is a seller. Now when he will sell the goods, he will pay some tax which is known as output tax. Of course he will collect the tax from the recipient, but at least it is this person's obligation to deposit the tax with the Government of India, output tax. But from this, what this person can do? He can claim input tax credit, that is tax paid on purchases, that is known as input tax. He can claim this as credit and he will pay only the balance amount. This is what the system is, simple. When you sell, compute the tax. What are tax you have paid on your purchases? If that is allowed to you as credit, deduct it and pay. This is what the normal thing. Now, for example, in the same example, what happens? For example, 13th November 2020, registration cancelled. For example, 13th November 2020, registration cancelled. When the registration is cancelled on 13th November till 12th November, or on the night of 12th November, basically not till 12th, simply see on 12th November 20 what you have. You must be having some raw material which you have purchased on 12th November. What you will be having now? If you are a person and you have purchased, for example, thread. I have purchased thread. From thread, for example, I am preparing socks. I am manufacturing socks. Now on 12th November 20, what I can be having? I can be having what? Can you tell me I can be having what? I can be having thread as it is. I can be having thread in socks, which is finished product. Maybe some socks are not ready, 50% ready. So I can be having what? Thread in work in progress. I hope you are understanding. I'll be having the raw material as it is. I'll be having the raw material in finished goods. I'll be having the raw material work in progress. When I purchased the thread, I must have paid some tax. Answer is yes. Now apart from thread, I can be having what? I can be having some plant and machineries which are helping in converting the thread into socks, plant and machinery. When I have purchased these plant and machineries, also I must have paid some tax. Similarly, I can be having some capital goods. So when I have purchased these capital goods, at that time also I must have paid some tax. So in all these all are my purchases. If you think carefully, these are nothing but your purchases. Whether thread in finished goods, thread in work in progress, plant and machinery and capital goods. These all are finished. These all are my purchases. When I must have purchased these, I must have paid some taxes also. Now, had I continued the business, had I continued the business, ITC would have been claimed by me. ITC would have claimed. I would have claimed the ITC, that is tax paid on purchases of these products. But since my registration is cancelled now, so that means if you don't have registration certificate, you cannot claim ITC. Input tax credit is allowed only when you are a registered person. That is why government says that you have to pay. What government says? You have to pay. You have to pay what? Higher of the following. Higher of what? Higher of what? On 12th November, that is one day prior to cancellation. 12th November 20, that is day prior to cancellation. Just day before cancellation. Whatever input tax credit you have, in thread, raw material, I call it as inputs, comma, inputs in work in progress, comma. This thread is nothing but input for me. Inputs in finished goods, in stocks, comma, plant and machinery, comma, capital goods. Whatever ITC you have, since you will never be able to claim this ITC, pay us this amount. We allowed this earlier. We allowed this earlier because you were doing business. You would have sold these stocks later on and ITC would have been indirectly recovered from you. Now, there is no scope for you to calculate tax on sale of stocks. Return this ITC which you have claimed earlier. Return it. Or, had you continued, and had you sold your finished goods, work in progress, raw material, etc., whatever output tax you would have paid. Had you continued the business, whatever output tax on such goods you have paid. Check whichever is higher. So whichever is higher, it is your obligation to pay the amount to us. Now detailed discussion will be done with the help of numerical. I mean, this cancellation of registration is normally a theory chapter. When we will discuss the full-fledged questions of ITC, full-fledged question of how tax paid on plant and machinery and capital goods is apportioned in different years, then only you can understand this output tax on such goods. So for the time being, for theory purpose, you can manage it till this point, that till 12th November, that is day prior to cancellation, whatever ITC you have in inputs, work in progress of inputs, finished goods inputs, plant and machinery, capital goods, that or output tax on these products, had you sold these with registration, whichever is higher, you have to pay to us. This is what my section 29 is. Now, one thing I forgot to tell you, in first category, when I have discussed with you, I have explained these notes also, manner of cancellation, time limit, and suspension, and this cancellation. Now, I forgot to tell you these in category 2. So, in category 2 also, we have notes. When the registration is cancelled by the proper officer. But there are only 2 notes. Note C and D of category 1 are applied as it is. That's it. Are applied as it is. Like at D note was that cancellation cannot be done without reasonable opportunity, and C note was suspension of cancellation. But in this case, since application cannot be filed, so only this suspension is relevant. When only officer has the power to cancel it, then answer is the suspension is determined by the officer. These are not relevant, no time limit applicable. And as far as manner of cancellation is concerned, only proper officer can cancel. That's it. This is what the discussion is. In case you have any problem, you can ask me. Or please raise your hand if the discussion of cancellation of registration is clear. Please raise your hand if this discussion is clear. Okay. So that's all from my side. Goodbye.